All right, this is going to be a little bit different than the 8x12 shed assignment that you should have already completed. This is going to be more for teams 3 and 4 so that they just get an idea of what their build will be like out on the job site. I'm not going to have you actually make a truss. I'm just going to have you actually virtually build it. You're working to get to this point right here, a completed roof assembly. We're not going to have these gable studs done yet. We're just going to be looking at putting in the trusses. Let's take a look at the trusses. You can see they are a repeating assembly. They're all virtually the same. These ones in the center have an additional feature on them. They have a gusset support. The ones out here on the ends do not, because this particular one right here will be completely sheathed, and this one out here is an architectural, it's aesthetics. It's for looks. It's the fly rafter, fly truss. I want you to notice something. Notice that the trusses are lined up with the studs, directly over the top of the studs, the common studs, and the studs are in direct alignment with the floor joist. That's by design. That's not required, but we prefer it in construction so that as we run systems up through stud cavities like electrical, heating, air conditioning, communication, wiring, plumbing, that we have unobstructed access from floor to floor. All right, so what do we need to get started? You need your blueprints. You need the overall shed ISO. You need the double top plate isometric. And you may also want to reference the actual drawing for the trusses themselves. You will also need the shed 2016 10x12 start, which will give you this SketchUp right here. It's my SketchUp, and I want you to start using it, so you'll save this as your own. You're going to start by assembling the double top plate. Let's take a look at the double top plate. You can see we have 2x4, 2x4, and 2x6 on the ends, which hang over 6 inches on each end. Let's go ahead and put that on there now. I want to start with this piece right here. Double click in. I want to grab a corner. M for move. I'm going to bring it up to position. Double top plate right there. Now I want to grab this guy. M for move. Grab a corner. I'm going to snap it into position right here, but remember it has to extend over 6 inches on each side. So I need to slide this thing 6 inches. And I can do that pretty simply by grabbing, starting the slide, pressing six, and then enter. All right, so that one's moved over 6 inches now. Let's put this double top plate on. M for move. Bring it on up. Snap it into position right there at the corner. There we go. And finally, last two pieces. M for move. Snap into position. Spacebar. M for move. Snap it into position. Move it out 6 inches. Six, enter. All right, there we have it. Double top plate is in place. Now it's time to place our truss assembly, which I've already created for you. All you've got to do is put the puzzle together. So let's get that thing. M for move. Remember, grab corners. You want to grab corners. And I like to find a common stud. Let's go with this first one right here and just snap it to that stud. All right, so now we know it's in the right position, left and right. Now we got to get it in the right position, side to side. So I'm going to slide this thing up now on the axis and lock it to the face of the double top plate, and then simply keep it on the axis. See how it stays red? There we go. Oh, it may have moved at the last second. Let me try that again. M for move, sliding out on the red. There we go. So I have my first truss in place. It's aligned perfectly over the common stud. And now I'm going to put the rest of them in place. What's the standard spacing for residential construction? 16 inch on center. So I start the slide, press and release control 1-6 for 16 inches, press enter. Start the slide, press and release control 1-6. side. That's the last one. Now I have the two specialized ones to put on. So let's do that now. I'm going to take this one and I am going to move it on down to the all the way out to the edge. But this one has to be modified. I need to pull the gussets off. So if I triple click in, whoa, uh-oh, problem. This one is a component with all the other ones. So if it's a component and I want to edit just that one component, I need to right click and make it unique. Now it's its own component. Now I can delete gussets front and back. Awesome. Now I can make another one of those, M for move. And if my fly rafter is 6 inches overhanging, if I come back 6 inches, I should be perfectly aligned with the wall, and that's exactly what I want. Now I'm going to select both of those, hold control to add the second one, M for move, press and release control to make a duplicate, and set them out on this side. One last thing, let's make that all a group. Right click, make group, and now my roof is one big group that I can move around. There you go. Now we don't have the gable studs on there yet. We'll work on that on a future drawing, but that looks pretty darn close. To finish this assignment, you will print this as an isometric drawing with your name and title block at the bottom. You will provide an estimate and cut list for all the material required to create these trusses.